Hi, fourth grade, and welcome back to Math, Mr. G. Today we're going to be continuing our work with our objective, working with word problems that involve multiple different steps. Yesterday we kind of got started with a few that had one or two steps and then finished up with the last one that had three big steps and a chart to go along with it. We're going to be continuing our work with that and seeing how these word problems can get more complex and how we can use different kinds of strategies to solve them, all starting, of course, with our cubes method. So without any time to spare, let's get started right away. So let's do this here. So cube on the side here. So the shop sold 12,789 chocolate and 9,324 cookie dough cones. This must be an ice cream shop. It sold 1,078 more peanut butter cones than cookie dough cones and 999 more vanilla cones and chocolate cones. Wow, we got a lot going on here. What was the total number of ice cream cones sold? All right, I'm going to build a chart before I do anything else. And we have one, two, three, four different kinds of cones. And it looks like we need to find a total. So I'm going to make this a very big chart so I have room for all of it. So we're going to need one, two, three, four, five rows. We have chocolate, we have cookie dough, peanut butter, vanilla, and the total. All right. So let's now circle our important numbers. 12,789 chocolate, so I have 12,789 and 9,324 cookie dough cones. So they tell us these two right off the bat without having to do any kind of math. It sold 1,078 more peanut butter cones and 999 more vanilla cones. Okay, so I'm going to underline my key words here. So we're dealing with cones, is of course our measurement here. But we're now going to look for our clue words. So I, for instance, see more here, which tells me I'm going to be potentially adding or subtracting, but probably adding. And more again, which probably tells me I'm adding again. And when I see total, I know I'm always adding because I add everything up. Let's box what's being asked of me. Let's eliminate. There's kind of a lot going on in this already. I don't want to eliminate anything at this point without getting it too messy. Now let's solve. So we already have chocolate and cookie dough. Let's see if we can do peanut butter next. So it sold 1,078 more peanut butter cones than cookie dough cones. Okay, so I have cookie dough, which is 9,234. I'm going to add 1,078 to it. 4 plus 8 is 12, carry the 1. 1 plus 3 is 4, plus 7 is 11. 1 plus 2 is 3, 9 plus 1 is 10. Okay, so peanut butter is 10,312 cones. Now let's find vanilla. Vanilla is 999 more cones than chocolate. So my chocolate is 12,789. Plus 999. Gonna be a lot of bundling and moving over this one, especially if you're dealing with all nines. 9 plus 9 is 18. Carry the 1. 1 plus 8 is 9. Plus another 9 is 18. Again, carry the 1. 1 plus 7 is 8. Plus 9, this time, is 17. Carry the 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. 1 plus nothing is 1. 1, 2, 3, comma. All right. 13,788 cones. Wow. Okay, so now we have to find the total, which means we have to add all of these numbers up. So I'm going to start with our 12,789. It's going to be a big number. 9,234 4. I'm going to add them. 9 plus 4 is 15. I'm sorry. 9 plus 4 is 13. Carry the 1. 1 plus 8 is 9. Plus 3 is 12. Carry the 1. 1 plus 7 is 8. Plus 2 is 10. Carry the 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. Plus 9 is 12. Carry the 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. So I have added chocolate and cookie dough. Let's add peanut butter next, which is 10,312. Three plus two is five. Two plus one is three. Zero plus three is three. Two plus zero is two. Two plus one is three. Okay, I've added my peanut butter. And last but certainly not least, let's add my vanilla. 13,788. 5 plus 8 is 13. Carry the one. 1 plus 3 is 4. Plus 8 is 12. Carry the 1. 1 plus 3 is 4, plus 7 is 11. 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 3 is 6. 3 plus 1 is 4. So 1, 2, 3, comma. Our total is 46,123 cones. Holy cow, that is a lot of ice cream. No pun intended. Okay, let's go on to the next one. My cubes method set up here on the side. This marker does not like me today. That's okay. Just like that. So there were 22,869 children, 49,563 men, and 2,872 more women than men at the fair. How many people are at the fair? So you have children, men, and women. Well, you know what that calls for. It's time for my box. Nice little chart there to organize three groups of people in a way that is easy to read and access. Children, men, and women. And just from me looking at the end there, how many people are at the fair? So that must mean I'm finding a total if I had to guess. So I'm going to put my total here, like so. I'll type it in. Boom. Okay. Now let's go through my cubes method. I'm going to circle important numbers, 22,869. They give that to me right off the bat. I'm going to put that right in my chart. I'm not even going to wait. 49,563 men. I'm going to put that in my chart as well. And then this one, 2,872 more. So I have to actually do something here with that one before I can put it in. So let's underline our keywords. We're dealing with children, men, and women. There's also more here, which tells me I'm adding. And it's also how many people were at the fair. So this how many in this case is looking for a total, means I'm adding. Let's box the question. Eliminate. I can eliminate there were, and I can eliminate at the fair. I mean, there's really not a whole lot to eliminate this one. This one's just really short. Now let's solve. Let's first, we can't find the total without finding the number of women first. So it says there's 2,872 more women than men. So I'm going to take the number of men and add 2,872 to it. So 49,563 plus 2,800. 72. 3 plus 2 is 5. 6 plus 7 is 13. Carry the 1. 1 plus 5 is 6. Plus 8 is 14. Carry the 1. 1 plus 9 is 10. Plus 2 is 12. Carry the 1. 1 plus 4 is 5. 52,435 women. A lot of people. All right, now I need to find the total. So I'm going to add up all three of these, just like we did in the past. I'm actually just going to add right from the bottom of this one, which is the total of women, to make things a little easier for myself. And I'll start with that top number, 22,869. Five plus nine is 14. Carry the one. One plus three is four. Plus six is 10. One plus four is five. Plus eight is 13. Carry the one. One plus two is three. Plus two is five. 5 plus 2 is 7. So total people, 75,304. Awesome. Okay, let's move on down to the next one. Now, this is an example from our assessment. So, as always, if you thought along this far, you'll have this example to work with. So, Walter's mother sends him to the grocery store with $22 to buy milk by the gallon. If milk costs $3 per gallon and Walter buys all the milk he can, how much money will he have left over? All right, I'm going to make a number tree here to make things easy for myself to see how close to 22 I can get with 3. So, I have 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. Zoom out a little bit. There we go. 18, 21, 24. Okay. So how close can he get? Well, he can get to 21 dollars spent. I have to get my red here, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 gallons of milk, but it's irrelevant to this question. We want to know how much money he'll have left over. So let's take the 22 and subtract it from 21, or 21 subtracted from 22 is just $1 left over. As always, I look forward to seeing your work, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.